Join me as I turn this into this. My DIY Halloween skeleton cages.
Hello, craft friends. Today I'm going to show you how to make this awesome craft. This Halloween caged animal cage skeleton craft. We have it in our front yard here and I am thrilled about it. I love how it turned out and I'm so excited about it. The best thing about this is I got a lot of the stuff at the dollar store, so it really didn't cost that much to make. Like, you know, this costs a little bit more, maybe the skeleton costs a little bit more, but it really was not that expensive of a craft and it was so fun to do. If this is your first time here, I do crafts that are obviously awesome to do individually, but also really fun to do with friends if you do a craft party or whatnot. Also, if this is your first time here, please consider subscribing below. Ring the little bell icon so you can get my videos, get notified when I do new videos. So I love to show you my crafts in fast forward first, in case you're short on time. So I'll show you them in fast forward first, and if you have time, stick around after. I'll do a full breakdown of materials that you need, and then also a slower craft tutorial to break down exactly how I did it so you can do it too. So without further ado, let's show you in fast forward. So welcome back. So not too hard, right? Not too hard. Let's talk about the materials you need. All the materials will be listed in the description below. A lot of them I got at the dollar store and they don't sell them online, but I will list something below that you can find on Amazon that's similar. But of course you're welcome to head on over to the dollar store and grab the materials that I got there. So first to start off, these are baskets, as you saw. So these are just baskets with the edges trimmed off. And so there's two different size laundry baskets that you'll need. Then you'll need whatever you want to put in the basket. So I chose a skeleton, which is a skeleton I found off of Amazon. It was a 36 inch skeleton. I'll have to go back and look, but I'll list it in the description below. And then these little birds, I don't know if you can see them, but these were at the dollar store. So these were all a dollar each. Also, these chains, you'll need three packs of chains per a basket. So I have six of these chains and these are at the dollar store. So I spent $6 on the chains. And then also zip ties. So I have some zip ties here and zip ties on different places that hold the craft together. And then last but not, oh, and black spray paint. So you'll need black spray paint. And then last but not least, you'll need these shepherd hooks. These are found, I found mine in the garden section of Home Depot. I think it was only like $15 or $16. If you do buy them on Amazon, they are a tiny bit more just because I think it's hard to ship them. So if you have a Home Depot around you, head there and find the shepherd hook and it's pretty inexpensive. So that's all the materials you need. Without further ado, let me show you the breakdown of how to make this craft.
So first I'm working on the smaller cages and I'm cutting just under the first horizontal line of the cage. I've seen people, if you want a bigger cage, I've seen tutorials where they just cut off the curved part of the rim, cutting through that thicker plastic, but for the ease of it, I just want to make it easy. So I'm just cutting below that first horizontal line of each basket. So just cutting through each of the little pieces there. And there you go. Then I'm spray painting. I started with the inside and I did a black spray paint and then I used also a black hammered spray paint, which is more of kind of like a really dark gray that gives it a little texture. So I used both. And after the insides dried, then I did the outsides. They don't have to be perfect. Just get them black. So next I work on assembling the baskets. I'm putting the skeletons inside of the basket. And the places I want the skeleton to kind of remain and be secure, I'm gonna twisty tie them to the basket. Like I wanted the hand up on the cage of the basket, and I'm gonna twisty tie that down. You can use fishing line, you can use string, you can use zip ties, you can use whatever you really feel. I had some black twisty ties, so I thought that was gonna be the best for me. I also wanted ways to disassemble this for storage, so that's also why I'm not gluing it. So you're more than welcome to glue it if you want as well. But I'm just securing the hand to the basket with a black twisty tie here, as you can see. So I'm just trying to figure it out. You just want to see the points of where you want the skeleton to stay secure, and just make sure it stays that way so when you assemble the basket, the inside props aren't falling all over the place. Next, I'm securing the two baskets together to make the cage. And how I'm doing this is using zip ties. I'm first using four different zip ties at four even spots around the basket. So if you imagine a clock, it would be at 12 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 6 o'clock, and 9 o'clock. And then I go back around adding a zip tie in between the ones I had already put there. So altogether, I have 8 zip ties holding the cage together to the two sides of the baskets together. I'm using zip ties because I want a way to disassemble it and store it so it's smaller. So this way I can just cut the zip ties, you know, stack the baskets together, and I'm able to store it a lot smaller. If you're not gonna store this in, like, if you have tons of storage and you don't need to break this down, then use like black wire and just wrap wire around it, or you can use zip ties and just leave it, either one. So for the smaller basket here, you see I'm securing the birds down. I'm using 3 different birds, and I want them placed all different places. You can imagine if I didn't secure them down and just place them in there, the minute I go to assemble everything, they're gonna move around. So same thing, I use twisty ties to just secure a few parts of the birds down to the cage. Again, if you're not trying to disassemble this, go ahead and glue them down. That's totally fine as well. So next I'm taking the chain, and their plastic chain, and the chain little loops come apart. So I'm spreading it apart and putting 3 different chains onto the big basket. So I have 3 chains equally spaced. For the small basket, I had to cut holes in the top, and I used zip ties to make some loops. And then I connected the chains to those loops. I like to use the black zip ties because you can't really see, them. Same thing to assemble the small basket. I put zip ties all around, securing the two sides of the basket together. I felt that the zip ties really were incognito and you couldn't really see it. So next, to assemble the whole thing, you push the shepherd's hook down into the dirt. Should be fairly easy depending on your dirt, but most shepherd hooks will be fairly easy. And then you just kind of place it how you want it. Remember that the loops of the chain come apart, so kind of play with that and take off parts that you don't want, add it to make a longer chain, another part. I totally kind of disassembled all the chains and kind of created my own, used some zip ties where I needed it, and just kind of fooled around and made it look really good and added things where I wanted it to add, and it turned out great. So here's the finished product. Here's my little bird cage. Full shepherd's hook, a skeleton, and the full thing. So cool.
So I hope your craft turned out so amazing. If you made it, please make sure to tag us. I love seeing your finished crafts. You can tag us at Social Crafts. That's at Social Crafts, or even hashtag Social Crafts is fine, and we'll see it there. And then also, I love being in touch with you outside of YouTube. So if you want, please follow us on any of our social media. That's Instagram, Pinterest, or Facebook. You can find it here. Instagram, Pinterest, or Facebook. Right here. And then also, don't forget to subscribe. You can subscribe over there as well. And subscribe, ring the little bell icon, and you'll be notified of our new videos. So thank you so much for your support. Love that you're here, and we'll see you next time.